Hi, it's Chester at Blue Peak and Computer Training, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a basic weekly planner. Let's look at some of the functionality you get with this. To start off with, you need to put the start date for your week in this cell. So if I change that back a week to the 22nd of the 3rd, 2021, it would update all the dates accordingly. Now, in terms of entering an activity in your weekly planner, what you've got is a drop-down list. So you can select, for example, one-to-one. And then if you wanted to add a bit more detail, press F2 on your keyboard. For example, you could say who it was with. If you want to add even more detail, you could go up to the review tab, go to notes, and then add a new note. And you can easily see if there's a note because you get that little red triangle that appears there. If the meeting lasts more than half an hour, you can just drag it down into the cell underneath and it will repeat the description. If I need to add more activities to my list, what I can do is go to the activities list and type in another activity, finance meeting, for example. Go to the weekly planner and down here, I've then got the finance meeting as an option. Okay, so let's see how we can build this weekly planner. Start this on a new sheet. I'll call this weekly planner. And a good place to start is in the page layout view. So go to view page layout. That way you can see whether you're fitting your planner on one page. I'm tempted to put this in landscape orientation. So on the page layout tab, orientation landscape. And I start by putting in the start date of my week, the Monday. And then dates that follow need to increment this date by one day. So I'd say equals B1 plus one, give me the following day. That's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Then I need to widen these columns to take up the width of this page. If I select them all across the top, just dragging across the letters, drag out the last one. They'll all be the same width. Drag it out until it fills the page. Then underneath the first date, type your Monday in, select the cell, drag that little green fill handle across, that'll increment the days of the week. Then you can put your times in. So you put time there. Now type in your first time. It's hours colon minutes, starting at 8:30. Put your next time in, and this expresses the increment that you want to repeat down this column. So you'll have to decide what increment that is for you. It might be an hour, quarter of an hour, whatever. Select both cells, then drag down to the time that you want to finish. And now you have all your times. Next step is to format your planner. And what I'm going to do is select everything but the dates at the top. Then I go to the Home tab, Format as Table. And I'm going to choose this medium blue design. All I need to do is click on OK here, and it does the formatting for me. I could also format the dates at the top. So if I select those cells, Home tab, blue fill, white text. I might center them. I could also center these days of the week. Okay, so now we need to add the drop-down list to each of these cells. So I'll create another sheet. I'll call this activity list. And we start by typing activity as a little heading. You can then put in your activity items. And click in here, and you also need to make this a table. The reason we're doing that is if you make it a table and you add new activities, your drop downs on the other sheet will automatically pick them up. If I click into any cell, format as table, I'll choose similar look. My table as headers, make sure that is ticked. Now you can give this a name. So with the table selected, click into this name box. We'll call this activity underscore descriptions. Then go back to your weekly planner, select all the cells in your weekly planner, go to the data tab on your ribbon, data tools group, click on data validation, go to Settings, Allow List, click into your source box, press the F3 key at the top of your keyboard, select the name that you gave to your table. If F3 doesn't work, just type it in with an equal sign in front of it. Then go to Error Alert, untick this option, Show Error Alert After Invalid Data is Entered. Click on OK, and you now have your drop-down list. If I chose one-to-one here, and tried to add a name to the description, I would press F2. Now what you'll notice is you get this little green triangle. Now it's not a problem that the green triangle is there, but if that annoys you, click on the cell, go to this little error button, go to error checking options, and then untick this option here, enable background error checking. Click on OK, and that will take it off. Okay, so you can continue to fill in your planner, and you are done. Thanks very much for listening. Hopefully you found it useful. If you have, please subscribe, and I'll see you next video.